Hi everybody, Adam here. Welcome back to our ongoing video series as we build the Brickmania New York Central Mohawk Steam Locomotive Kit. Super excited about this locomotive. I think it's going to look really amazing moving around our layout. And you know, just so much detail packed into this kit. It's been both a fun and extremely challenging build as we've been moving through this. But lots of cool stuff to show you this time. We've actually reached the point of having a almost complete locomotive. We've got the, you know, minus the cab, everything exists and is all put together. Still a few little extra details to put on once the cab is added at the back, but really starting to take shape. And you can see just so many details packed into the model. Up here at the front, we've got the numbering printed on the bricks here for the train. And you can't see it yet, but there's a Brickstuff light in the front there, which once everything is powered up, should turn on and light the front of the train there. So fingers crossed that will work as planned. And you know, on the sides of the train here, just a ton of piping detail to really capture all the different greebles and details of an actual locomotive, which is both impressive and, you know, I found to be really difficult to work through a lot of different lengths of all that piping, which was difficult to sort through. And you know, tough to get them all just on in the perfect way. I think there's still several pieces that I need to go back and kind of bend a little bit more to get the shapes perfect. But you know, now that it's on there, I think that you know, we're getting pretty close to something that that looks pretty amazing. And you'll notice up on the top of the train as well, lots of additional details there. You'll notice that there are lots of these tube plus minifigure hand components that are across the train. Very difficult to put those together with your fingers. They do give you a tip in the book of how to use a brick, you know, one of the bricks in the set to make that come together a little easier, but still very challenging on your fingers to get that all together. But you know, just lots of texture across the whole outer body of the locomotive, which is really cool to see. And really excited about these wheels with their rods on them. I think these are gonna work out quite well, and it should be a lot of really neat movement as the train moves around the layout. So really looking forward to seeing those in action. Saw a little bit of how they work before the motors went in. So we'll see how it looks once everything's powered up and those motors fire up. You know, again, fingers crossed that everything works, because I cringed, you know, to think that I might have to go back in to mess around with any of the wiring inside here. I think it would be pretty difficult to peel some of these layers back apart. So let's take a look at the other side of the locomotive now. So you can see on this side of the locomotive, a lot of similar details, still lots of piping here, great rods across the wheels, still a few bits of the piping that, you know, like over here that I need to try to potentially bend and shape a little bit more so they line up with the ideal shape in the instructions. But on the whole, really taking shape. And you know, one of the details that really pops for me is you got this little American Locomotive Company printed tile here on the side of the locomotive. Shows up on both sides, which is really cool. And you know, you can't really see it when you move farther away, but I like that about this model, that there's things that you can see up close and appreciate, and then there's different details that pop the farther back you go, And I think that's going to make for a really fun locomotive to have on the layout. We can have it running around and the track, and there'll be things that you can appreciate there. Or if it happens to be sitting on a siding and people can look at it there, there'll be different things that they see and can appreciate about it. So really happy overall with all the details that they've included. And you'll notice at the back here, as I mentioned, we've still got the cabin area to finish up, and with that, we've got all the wires coming out. So we've got a light that's going to go in the cab area, I believe. We've got a power wire here that's going to go across with the motor wires to the tender. And then everything will get hooked in over there to the battery. So, getting really close to having a finished product here. The part pile is dramatically shrinking here. Not that much more to go here before we're done, which is really great because that means we're getting close to putting this train through its paces on our layout. And as I mentioned, in addition to running that locomotive around, we'll have it pull the New York Central caboose kit from Brickmania as well. So I think that's going to make for a really awesome train moving around our layout. And fingers crossed, as I said, all our wiring will work out of the box, and we won't have any troubleshooting to do there. But really excited with where the kit is at. And if you have not subscribed to the channel, highly recommend that you do so that you don't miss out on any of our upcoming videos, but especially the next couple videos for this awesome kit. We will do another video upon completion of the build to kind of put it through its paces here on the workbench, so you can see some of the lighting and see how the finished product looks. And then we will do a video out on the layout where you can see the locomotive moving around and see just how it works and functions. So really excited about all of that, and hope you will you'll subscribe and join us for those upcoming videos. As always, thank you very much for watching. I really appreciate it, and looking forward to seeing you again soon. Take care. Bye.